my wife.
This is for the world's greatest mom, a person.
Good morning, everybody. All right, welcome to Mother's Day 2021. This is our ladies' service, and we want to go ahead and say in advance how thankful we are for all of our mothers. Thank you, ladies, that are participating today. We're excited about that, that the ladies are going to come in and minister to us this morning. So with that being said, we're going to pray, and then I'm going to turn the service over to our master of ceremonies, Miss Barbara Ford. So let's go to the Lord in prayer, ask Him to bless our time. Lord, thank You for this good day, Lord, and thank You for this Mother's Day. Lord, thank You for our mothers. And Lord, we ask You right now, Lord, as we continue on with the morning service, Lord, that You will bless our efforts. Lord, that You will touch and anoint the ladies as they lead the service today, Lord. And we ask right now, Lord, that You get favor with our efforts. Lord, that the lost are saved. And Lord, that You are pleased, Lord, with what we attempt to do for You today. We love You, we thank You, and we trust You for a good Sunday morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Ladies and gentlemen, big open door welcome to the Master of Ceremonies, Miss Barbara Ford.
Happy Mother's Day to all you beautiful ladies. Any birthdays or anniversaries today? Going once, going twice, in Pastor Scott voice. Any birthdays or anniversaries? If not, we'll just go into praise and worship.
Thank you.
Thank you. to the truth, didn't know what I had. I was running, I was searching, but every place I turned for healing left me more broken than the last. Take me back to the place that feels like home, to the people I can depend on, to the faith that's in my bones. Take me back to a preacher and a verse where they see me at my worst, to the love I had at first. Oh, I wanna go to church. Tried to walk on my own, but I wound up lost. Now I'm making my way to the foot of the cross. It's not a trophy for the winner, it's a shelter for the sinner, and it's right where I belong. Take me back to the place that feels like home, to the people I can depend on, to the faith that's in my own. Take me back to a preacher. Thank you.
introduce our prayer by Melissa Moody.
Good morning, everyone, and happy Mother's Day to all you mothers. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Lord, we come to you today just thankful. Lord, I thank you for my mother being here today, and I thank you for all the other mothers that are here today. Lord, I thank you for the ones that are in heaven with you today as well, Lord, looking down on us. Lord, we ask you right now just to bless this service, bless the speakers, and bless the reading of the scripture as it is read today. We love you and thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Now we have Miss Rosa Butler.
I couldn't do Mother's Day without reading these verses. Out of Proverbs, what God's Word says about a virtuous woman. And when I open my Bible, the first thing I see is I've got written down here, July 13th, 2013, at 3 p.m. That's when we celebrated my mom's going home funeral, her going home services, and these were the scriptures that Pastor Rogers shared with us on that day. So it makes sense to me that I would have to share them on Mother's Day to honor those mothers that are still living, but also those mothers that have gone on to be with the Lord. So join me in reading Proverbs chapter 31, starting at verse 10. Who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband does safely trust in her, that he shall have no need of spoil. She will do him good and not evil all the days of her life. She seeketh wool and flax and worketh willingly with her hands. She is like a merchant ship. She brings forth food from afar. She rises also while it is yet night and giveth meat to her household and a portion to her maidens. She considers a field and she buys it. In the fruit of her hand, she plants a vineyard. She girdeth her loins with the strength and strengthen her arms. She perceiveth that her merchandise is good. Her candle goeth out, not out by the night. She layeth her hands to the spindle, and her hands holdeth the staff. She stretcheth out her hand to the poor. Yea, she reacheth forth her hands to the needy. She is not afraid of the snow, for her household, for all her household are clothed with scarlet. She maketh herself coverings of tapestry. I'm sorry, y'all can't quite pronounce some of these words. Her clothing is silk and purple. Her husband is known in the gates, and he sitteth among the elders of the land. She maketh fine linen, and she sells it, and delivereth her girdles unto the merchant. Strength and honor are her clothing, and she shall rejoice in time to come. She opened her mouth with wisdom, and in her tongue is the law of kindness. She looketh well to the ways of her household, and eateth not the bread of idleness. Our mothers are not slow. There's nothing slow about our mothers. They are continually working behind the scenes for us. Her children arise up and call her blessed, her husband also, and he praiseth her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou art the excellence of them all. Give her of the fruit of her hands, and let her own works praise her in the gates.
Now we have Miss Linda Hanna for offering a prayer.
First, I would like to say we give honor to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Yeah. Happy Mother's Day again to each and every one here today. We are so blessed to be here as mothers, and we are so blessed to have had a mother. Everyone here had a mother. We may not be here with you today, but you had a mother. And Miss Barbara, I don't know exactly how to do this, but I'm gonna do it my best way. First Kings 3:16, if you would read that, you would see a choice that was made by a mother. Solomon had to make a choice. There was two babies, two mothers. One baby died, the mother switched it around. The king had to make a choice. He said, well, bring me the sword. We'll just divide the baby in half. We'll give one half to this mother, the other half to this mother, because they could not come, they could not get the real mother to tell the truth. So you know what Solomon said? Bring me that sword, and I'll get the truth out of him. So you know what? That real mother, that true mother said, uh-uh, don't touch that baby. Give it to her. So you know what? It's something to be a true mother. And we thank God, and we do not want to judge that other mother, because you know what? At one time in our lives, we were in the positions where we didn't make good choices either. So today we have a chance to make a start. Happy Mother's Day, and let's bring that Mother's Day money on fire. Let's bring it back. Yeah. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for the blessings here today. Thank you for our pastor. Thank you for his mate. Thank you for everyone in all the everyone in their respective positions. God, we ask that you just touch our services today. Thank the ladies that have came before us. Thank the ones that's coming after us. And Lord, we just love you. We give you glory for everything. Thank you for the blessings of our offerings today. And we know that it's going to be used to the edifying of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we pray and give all the honor and the glory. Come forward with the ladies first and the children. Tithes and offerings. Ladies first, children, ladies and children. And the children can go to their Sunday school classes. Glad to see y'all. This was a shock. Men, come forward, please. The men, come forward. This world's coming to an end, and it won't be long. The party's gonna start and go on and on and on. I'll be singing with the saints at the morning light, ringing in the day, cause there is no night, saying goodbye to the heartache, trouble, and pain. I'll be sitting at the throne with an angel band, now turn this back over to Pastor Scott. I'm sorry to the mistress, Miss Bob.
Netta, you'll play the slideshow.
Because God needed someone to love the least and the little into a real whole people. He knew that to love is to suffer, so God made a mother. God said, I need someone to get up at midnight, scoop up the most fragile of humanity, close to her warmth, sing a lullaby to soothe so the whole house doesn't wake up, and rock until pieces come, though she can hardly stand. So God made a mother. I need somebody strong enough to open a pickle jar, yet gentle enough to tie a ponytail. Somebody who prizes refrigerator art, feeds the pets so they're not forgotten, works hard over a meal, feeds the family and friends, with holds her own appetite until everyone has had their full before she has hers. Turn a rainy sleepover into an indoor dance party, and the next day, through squinted eyes, says, come back real soon and mean it. So God made a mother. God said, I need somebody willing to sit up all night with her teen daughter after the first heartache, then dry her eyes and say, God's going to work it out. I need somebody who can shape a volcano for a science fair experiment, have a full change of clothes and a purse, who can make a fort of pillows, organize snacks, clean mud tracks, and who, getting son's license and sissy's piano recital, will finish her 40-hour week by Tuesday at noon, then, painted from the lack of sleep, put in another 72 hours. having stinky floors, dirty ovens, and happy kids. So God made a mother. God had to have somebody who would look into her husband's eyes and say, I believe in your decision, and I'm your biggest fan. Not love, confrontation, but stand for what is right. When the neighbors lost a loved one, be the first one to respond with a meal and prayers throughout the night. So God made a mother. God said, I need somebody steady enough to not stop praying over that prodigal, yet gentle, excited enough to welcome him home with a soup and a hug. Will stop her laundry folding for an hour to have a deep talk with her daughter whether she should go with rosy or fuchsia lip gloss for her first prom. It had to be somebody who'd make manners a priority and ice cream runs frequently. Somebody to pray, serve, sing, cook, clean, and worship, and feed, and buy the milk and replenish the toilet paper cabinet. Encouraging texts to her son while she embodies Proverbs 31 and finish a hard week's work with a 5-mile drive to church. Somebody who'd bail a family together with the soft, strong bonds of sharing, who would laugh and then sigh and then reply with smiling eyes when her daughter says she wants to spend her whole life doing what mom does. So God made a mother.
My mother is godly, wise, strong, and she has been through so much. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. I love you.
I would say strong, loving, and prayerful.
I will say that I love my mom with all my heart, and she has loved me unconditionally. Even if I was right, even if I was wrong, my mom always supported me. She never turned her back on her child.
My mom is a teacher, a provider, and a giver. Love you, Mom.
Strong, patient, and kind.
My mother Jean is caring, loving, and attentive.
My mom is more than a fearless woman. She's more than a superhero. She's more than a best friend. She's my life.
This is for the world's greatest mom, a person that never give up, always fight to the end, always been a rock in a hard place. May God continue to bless you. I love you, and you're forever mine. I love you, Mom.
My mom is hardworking, caring, and resilient.
Strong-minded.
Dependable. Loving.
Our rock. Servant, unconditional love.
Remarkable, resilient, reliable.
She's beautiful, caring, and hardworking.
God-fearing.
Hi, Lottie Brown, John Kim Baker. You know I always got to start off with that. But you're going to always be my Humpty. Happy Mother's Day, Mama. I love you.
The luckiest woman ever, and that works.
My mom is beautiful, loving, and courageous.
Three words to describe our mom is selfless, loving,
beautiful.
We love you.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's.
Thank you, Netta, for that. We're going to have two testimonies from two courageous women in our church, and they are very dear to my heart. First, I'd like to call up Miss Barbara Chavis.
Good morning, everyone. For those of you who may not know me, my name is Barbara Chavis.
I started coming to Open Door Church last January 2020, when the pandemic first started in a lot of places. On January 19th, I found out I had breast cancer. My doctor told me the most devastating news. I didn't know how to handle it. I was raised in church with my grandpa. He was a pastor. And those were the best times of my life, growing up in church and being with him and the rest of my family. But as I got older, I kind of swayed away and started doing other things. But I always felt like God was tugging at my heart, telling me to come on back. Well, he tugged so much, he got my attention. He got my attention really hard with the cancer. So my Uncle Jerry and my Aunt Carol asked me to come to church here. I came to church and I felt so welcome. Pastor Rick and Mary Beth and everyone here were so kind to me. They prayed for me. They stood by me. All of you have been so good to me. This church is wonderful. And I want to say I thank God for bringing all of you into my life. I thank God that through the whole year, it was so hard. It was the toughest year of my life, but it was also the best year of my life. And I want to say I thank you and I praise him for all the good he's done for me. Yeah. I want to say I'll never stray again. I'll always put him first and my family first. And if anything I can ever do for anyone here, you please let me know. If I can't do it, I'll find a way to do it for you. Because you all been good to me and been with me through the hardest experience of my life. I want to thank Pastor Rick for asking me to come up here. I'm kind of nervous. I'm not used to being in front of a crowd talking. But I want to say that in March, before I started my chemo, when I had to go into the hospital for my portacath operation, I was really nervous, and I was thinking, God, what is next for me? What is next? Before I had to go in for anesthesia, I went to the restroom, and there on the floor, on the very front of a newspaper, it was wrapped up, and you could see one word, faith. I think that was nothing but a message to God for me when I needed it the most. I told Pastor Rick and church about it, and it was moving. It was nervous. I'm like, what does this mean for me, you know? But God got me through the chemo, 16 rounds, the year of surgery. He got me through 30 rounds of going through radiation. And I'm glad and happy to say thanks to God that I'm cancer-free right now. I also want to say I'm grateful to God that